beautiful and talented and hilarious Miss Robbie Turner!
But it is a problem. It's my name. You know, I find that still a lot of people call me Lisa. Yeah. Wrong! My name is Liza. Liza has a Z in it. Well, for instance, somebody will come up to me on the street and say, "Hello, Lisa, how are you?" Say, "Fine, thank you, but it's Liza." Or somebody will say, "Lisa, what a nice hat you have on." I'll say, "Thank you very much, but my name is Liza. And that's my hair." You can see what I'm... Anyway, I've been trying to figure out a final solution to this whole thing, and I think I've come up with the answer. Jack? It's Liza with a Z, not Lisa with an S, because Lisa with an S folks not. It's Z instead of S, Y instead of B. Simple as can be, see Liza? Again, it's Liza with a Z, not Lisa with an S, because Lisa with an S folks not. It's Z instead of S, Y instead of B. Simple as can be, see Liza? Now, if my name were Ada, I'd be Ada. Even backwards, I'd be Ada. Or if my name were Ruth, then I'd be Ruth. Because with Ruth, what can you do? Or Sally, or Margaret, or Ginger, or Faye. But when you're a Liza, you always have to say, it's Liza with a Z, not Lisa with an S. Because Lisa with an S goes, it's Z instead of S, Y instead of B. And symbols can be Z, Liza. Oh, and that is only half of it. The way they treat me cruelly. How often I remember someone saying, "There she goes, Lisa Minelli, or Minelli, or Mineola, or Minelli, or Minelli." So is it a wonder I very often cry? It's M-I-double-N, then E-double-L-I. You double up the N, that's the nine. Then E-double-E-L, end up with an I. That's why you say Minelli. Liza Minelli. It's Italian. Blame it on Papa. What can I do? It's E instead of S, Y instead of B, it's simple as B, C, Liza, then M-I-double-N, then E-double-L-I, you double up the N, that's not, then E-double-E-L, ending with an I, that's what you say, Minelli, Liza Minelli, it's easy, it's easy. I told a couple of friends of mine this truly dramatic, absolutely true story. And it just so happened that these friends of mine are songwriters. And guess what happened? Right? Truly terrific, absolutely true song. Gather around, I've got a story to tell about a Manhattan lady that I know very well. She lives at 5 Riverside. Her name is Shirley DeVore, and she traveled round the world to meet the guy next door. Well, there was trouble inside apartment 29E, cause Shirley's mother and dad were as upset as can be. They said, "We hate to complain, dear, and we don't like to grouse, but you're nearly 32, you should get out of the house." You gotta ring them bells, you gotta ring them bells, you gotta make them sing and really ring them bells. It's a she was loath to admit. And she had never been loved, which didn't bother her a bit. And so she sat and she thought for hours on end, and said, I'll go to chase Manhattan where I got me a friend. And so she borrowed a bow and called to W.A. and told her mother and dad that she was up and away. I'm gonna travel the continent a month, maybe two, and haul me home a horse if it's the last thing I do. You gotta ring them bells, you gotta ring them bells, you gotta make them sing and really ring them bells. It's such a happy thing to hear them sing a lick. She went to Madrid and met a handsome senor, but he liked to throw the bull and he was no matador. She also went down in Brussels, in Mallorca and Rome, till someone said, try Brooklyn. Cause it's the kind of a town where you'll be likely to fall, and all the journey for me, shit, they find the Balkans a ball. You gotta bring them bells. It's such a happy thing to hear them sing a thing. You gotta ring them bells. And so she went up to Dubrovnik at the very first day. She met a guy on the beach who took her reason away. Yes, it was love at first sight. What a beautiful scene. She said, my name is Cheryl DeVore. He said, I'm Norm Saperstein. She said, are you from New York? He said, that can't be denied. I've got a swell to three at number five, Riverside.
Five Riverside Drive in New York? That's where you live? That's where I live. Five? Are you sure? As if that wasn't enough, for Shirley thought she'd gone deaf when he told her his apartment there was 29F. Guess she was E, he was F, and they had not.